mowing this guy?
I'm just doing a little mowing here for him.
Who owns this property now?
It's owned by the Evangelical Wesleyan Church. This is our campground.
Oh, so you're involved in the organization? My grandfather was a teacher here in 1927. Do they have any history books or anything?
We don't. Your best bet on this would be to go over to the Lutheran Church, cross over there. They have more information about this than what we do. They have pictures that go way, way back. These two buildings were one building. Across this, there was a portico that went across there, made it one building, and there was columns that went out front. I mean, there was kind of a breezeway through here, columns and different things out on that side. And I mean, it was really quite fancy, and then kind of a balcony across up above. I mean, it was quite elaborate.
Right.
But when we got it, that had all been taken down and to where they are like you see now. We had used that building there, the main floor. In this corner was our kitchen, where that door is there on this south side, and with rooms up above. This one they're still using. The end of July, the last usually about a week and a half of July, we have our meetings. We have a camp meeting here, conference and camp meeting.
Yeah. What religion is it?
It's a Methodist.
Methodist.
Methodist doctor in background here, and so it's going to be 3 weeks. We're going to have a weekend meeting here.
Okay.
And then after that, we'll close it up for the winter. That building there, as soon as we can get some things, we got some stuff stored in there right now. As soon as we can get them where they need to be and so forth, that building is going to come down. Underneath the kitchen part on this side, there's only one floor joist that's not broke. in the middle of it there.
Yeah.
So you go in and you tread carefully.
Uh-huh.
You don't jump, you don't bounce, you don't send a whole army in there.
Uh-huh. My grandfather, he went to school here, and I think during the wintertime they came here because the kids were needed on the farms during the summer, and then they wanted additional training, and then they came here. And I got a picture of him standing in front of the building with a bunch of people. It was like 1909.
These were the original three buildings. This was the bathrooms.
Oh, okay.
Originally,
we're
using it for our
garage and tinker
maintenance
room.
Shed.
Yeah.
That only had two stalls in it on each side. That one is just getting unsafe.
I mean,
you don't see it so much from the outside, but you look inside.
Inside is worse.
Yeah, it's really bad.
Yeah.
You can see right over here, there's another place that's sinking in. Sinking down.
Oh, yeah.
There. And we got a pump here where there's kind of a beam underneath, and then it drops off that way.
Yeah.
And kind of stays. This way, it's not quite so bad. But it has this beautiful woodwork in it.
Oh, yeah. That kind of looks like the sills that I had when the house I was growing up. Actually, the same color paint.
Mm-hmm. It's beautiful.
Hopefully you'll preserve maybe save that before the thing goes down.
Some of that we'll salvage what we can salvage out, but what's good to salvage. places that's got this wings going on. And I think that right there is probably one reason why it's not coming down.
The low bearing beam.
Yeah. Got these army cots, army bunks. They're not the most comfortable, but when you're a teenager, you don't care.
Yeah, when you're tired too after a day's work of running around.
This was the
women's bathroom, which those of how that hasn't been in use for about 20 years. Mm. Kitchen area in there. We had tables back here to eat, back, set back here to eat too. So. See how much things have settled. This yeah. door won't even open all the way. Yeah, we're.
Let's see what year. 1949.
That's when that was set. And they make reference to this being a recreation hall in the records of that. Thank you.